look around you, man, you can find inspiration, you can find discouragement. It all depends on you. Perception is everything. Some people just hear another song. Some people hear the greatest. A nigga used to have no chill. Nowadays I bump side A. Traffic going bumper to bumper, stuck on the highway.
See, there are people who can get access, but they just stay away. Oh, I can't touch that. Oh, I can't this. You have a lot of people who are very selfish about it because they're like, yeah, although I do have access to them, I can go pull up on them. Boom, boom, boom. I don't do it because of my reputation. Because now I'm going to be seen with the one who said this about this group, this bank, this, that. And it's like, is that your brother or is it not your brother? Mm-hmm. Because we're potentially talking about life or death now. I'm not saying go out there on a damn media tour and bring the cameras. Right. I'm saying pull up in the heat of the night, put on 30 hoodies and 10 masks, whatever you got to do.
30 hoodies.
Go in there looking like a straight up alien. Like, who the hell? What is that? Good. Right. So that nobody recognizes you if that's what you need to do. We know how it feels when we got to pull up on that one person who we know is they're not being themselves. Like, they're not being who we grew up to know them as. And we got to check on them because now they're doing stuff that's not of their norm. Mm-hmm. Got to pull up. Are you all right? What's going on, man? I saw this. Boom, boom, boom. That's real love. But some of them are nervous.
Yeah.
I've talked to a number of them. And I told them, everything you're saying, I hear you. But I can't get past the fact of how weak you're being. Mm. Who are you afraid of? So the media is going to try to spin the fact that you went and consoled your brother and gave him a hug. You know, the media is not trusted by the people for the vast majority. We can be controlled by the media on certain topics. But if they see that you went and hugged his brother and that's it, yeah, the media can put whatever caption and all that. But if you be like, no, I went because I care about this man and leave it at that. Don't say no other comments. That's it. Mm-hmm. Let people say whatever the hell they want to say. I don't give a damn. If I could access that brother, I would sit down with him and really talk to him. And not just that, but you got to address the nutritional side, because when you get on those drugs, your body chemically is being out of whack. Mm. So now you got to get a nutritionist. You got to get an herbalist. You have to get somebody who can get in there and help detox. Yeah. Which all of us need that. Yeah. Just so you know, radiation, all these other chemicals, whatnot. But if you love somebody enough, you'll go check on them. If you can't do it, you'll find the person who can. It's just that simple. It's not no excuses. I don't get all that. It's like, what? Okay, your reputation. You ain't got one. Because if I get out and say what the hell you just said to me and I tell the people who said it, your reputation is over. Hmm. So let me give you this chance to do what the hell you need to do and go check on your brother.
Right.
The hell you called me for?
I know the Honorable Louis Farrakhan had checked on him on a few occasions.
Absolutely.
On Kanye.
I'm sure, brother. I don't know how many times Kanye has talked to the minister. You know, he made that publicly known. He calls the minister sensei.
Sensei.
Come on, brother. So that's the number one. That's the number one. But again, you know, he's a man. Kanye, you know, he's dealing with what he's dealing with. Again, once you get to a certain point where you're not able to control yourself because of outside interventions. We know how this is. I don't know. I got family who've been on drugs. If y'all ever seen people who got on that stuff and you know how they are. Matter of fact, you know them so well. And how they get when they on that, they done had a fourth, fifth, ooh, it's going to be a long night, y'all. Y'all want to stay here? I'm going to go ahead. Right. Okay, because you know how Jeffrey gets.
But it's scary in some instances.
It is. You know, and we got to be honest with our people, man. We have to love them enough to tell them the truth, but then also be willing to give them a solution to address their problem. And if they want to take it, good. If they don't, hey, they can't say nobody offered it to them.
Right.
They can't say that. They can't say, no, I didn't nobody. No. I walked right up to you. I handed it to you. Don't get out here and say, no, just say you were unwilling to take it, because some people don't want help. And that is true, too. Right. That's a small percentage, but they do exist. You know, so yeah, that ego is a thing, too. But it's just layers to it, brother. When it comes to him and people like him, it's layers to it.
You know what it feels like? It almost feels like you're trying to stop someone who, Jeffrey, who's had that fifth, but he's going to the car.
Yeah.
And he's got the keys.
Yeah.
And we're standing between him and the car, and he keeps pushing past everybody to get to the car.
Yeah.
It's like, bro.
I know.
It's me, the door, and you.
Mm-hmm.
If I have to knock you out to keep you from getting in the car and potentially not just offing yourself, but now there's everybody else on the road. Bro, I cannot not hit you in this moment and put you on the ground.
Sometimes especially with some of our people. Y'all may not like this, but that may be necessary. Hmm. Because which one brings a better benefit in the outcome? I had to knock Jeffrey out. He gonna sleep good. But he lives. He gonna live. He not even gonna remember getting knocked out. Right. He gonna wake up, yeah. Got the cover on him. He hard up. Good to see you up, man. Hey, you knocked out early. Don't tell him nothing, y'all. Don't. It's sad because again, our people are hurting, man. Like it's a lot going on.
It just feels like Jeffrey's gonna hate you when he wakes up, though.
If he remembers,
he'll be embarrassed. Somebody videotaped it. Now he's mad at you.
And you know what? Guess what? At that point. This is where the accountability and responsibility comes in.
Okay.
What are you embarrassed about, Jeffrey? What you embarrassed about? Well, you didn't have to hit me. You didn't have to get drunk and get uncontrollable to where you almost took your own life. Or probably somebody else's, Jeffrey. My responsibility as your brother is to want for you what I want for myself. I want to live. I want you to live too. Mm-hmm. So can you please help us all by not doing what you know is going to lean you into that behavior? Just do that for us. Can you do that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that might not. That conversation might not work.
You see,
yeah,
it may after, not.
But not the day after, but maybe 3 days later.
No, exactly. Like we said, you if he remembers,
yeah. Or like a month later.
Day after, hey, they ain't trying to hit that.
It
shit
depends. No, for real. Like I said, it's not easy just talking. Some of y'all are like, I feel it's relative. It depends on the person. Right. Depends on the situation. Some of us are bigger than our uncles.
Yeah.
He ain't got no choice but to listen. All right, nephew. All right. You know, it happens. But if it's the opposite, where they, you know, at least you made the attempt. And he will respect you. Even if he get embarrassed with it for a while, it's going to take time. Depends on the person.
I gotta confess something. I've been in these positions.
I knew he was going to say this.
Yes.
Go ahead.
That's why you're going hard about it.
He has no faith in black people, period. He has no
That's
faith.
Not true.
None.
That's not true. That's not true. Killer Mike came at me like that. Like, what do you love about black people?
And I was sitting at home because I missed that episode. I was like, yeah! Get that motherfucker!
Here's the funny part. A little bit later on in the same conversation, he said, yo, the running back's job is to run down the field. Mm-hmm. Defensive back's job is to push him. Mm-hmm. Somebody has to play that other position.
Right.
That the reason why I let it go is because that's me.
Happens.
I don't play. I don't cheer on the running back. I want you to do better. I want you to do great. I'm not on this everything's great
let you
participation
be
trophy. Mm. I don't rock like that. Mm-hmm. And when I push back against black people to the point where Killer Mike is asking me, well, what do you like about black people? name me something you like about black people.
Right.
Three things you like about black people.
Dang, it caught
me off guard because I was like, I couldn't really
go watch that. Because
I'm like, do I really come? My only thought was, damn, I come across like, and I had a bunch of, I wanted to, but I was like, man, I really come across like that to you? Like, you really think that's what
that's a good moment to reflect to see sometimes if there's truth to it. That's
It caught me off guard right on the spot. However, a little bit later on, he showed me that I was right because he explains my circumstances.
I get you, math.
Bro.
I get both sides. Don't
help him. Because he swears I'm anti because I don't think
that you're anti. I just think that you have very little faith.
In
very
what?
Little faith.
In what?
In black people as a whole. And I don't knock you.
I trust black people to do what they're going to do. I have faith in that. Once you show me what it is, I react accordingly. My whole thing is it's not in me to pander or talk nice to you.
It's not pandering.
It feels like pandering.
But this is where the Mecca that has no children becomes like prevalent to me. You know what I'm saying?
Okie dokie.
Sometimes you have to speak up. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you have to give them something to kind of look up with. You keep telling them, oh, you keep messing up, you'll never get it right. It gets programmed. You'll never get it right.
I don't say that to people. I don't say that to people.
Don't make us make a compilation, Mac.
Go on and tape.
Make us make a compilation.
But
sometimes, like, if you just speak hope, you know, it might awaken something that'll cause a change. Like, if this person believes in me, maybe I should start believing in me too.
Okay. It takes one.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay, where he's getting that from is we mostly discuss rappers and artists.
Gotcha.
And the way I treat rappers and artists. My thing is, I don't believe most of these rappers are artists. I think you're here for the fame. I think you're here for the clout. I think you're here for the money. I think you're here for the look.
Good percentage, y'all.
I am a steward of the culture and the art. Mm-hmm. So you are anti me. You're in the way. Mm. And I don't have any breaks for them. I'm not talking them up because I want you out the way. You're in the way of a Math Hoffa, Champ with his production, KK with his video, Aaron with his singing. You're in the way of real talent. So I don't have any patience or breaks for them. And I'm not going to talk them up. I'd like you to leave. I'm showing you the door.
You know what? Okay. I get that. Right. I get both ends of that. Okay. So I'll say it this way. Because I share that. The only thing with me is I always go to the source of the problem. I don't attack us. I attack it.
Okay.
Mm. That way it prevents you from looking like an enemy to your own people. Mm-hmm. Even when we say black people this, black people that. Well, first of all, none of us have met all of us. That's the first thing. It's like black women saying, well, y'all know how y'all niggas are. Oh, excuse me, sis. Hey, I'm for the reason. Nice to meet you.
I'm different.
We have met all of us, right? Right. You know, same thing. You know all these females. Whoa. You know, brother, yeah, she got you on child support. That one. Right. Not all of them. Right. You know, but we defeat ourselves quick. That way we walk outside and everybody's Tyrone. Everybody's Keisha. Why? Because we damned all of them to that.
Right.
You never met them. Then you won't have no belief in them at all because, hey, y'all know, man, y'all all blah, 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 blah. That is, I say at times that generalizations are the language of the ignorant because it's easier. Rather than me sitting down and individually learning about you, I'm just going to put y'all all in a blanket statement. Y'all niggas are the same. When it's like, no, that brother clearly is different from that brother. This brother got gifts and talents that this brother may not have. You have gifts and talents that this brother may not have. You compliment each other. Man, that's dope. What's your name? That's what we should do. We need to learn more about one another. Right. That way it'll help us to prevent from putting this heat and this energy from this situation on them, on you. Right. That's how we have to do it. I would just say I would encourage us to do that because, again, although I can't stand the majority of today's so-called rap, I know who is sanctioning that. This enemy is eating off of that. He's letting it, do that. Okay, so I got to go at him. Right. I got to go at him. I have to go at the prison industrial complex. I have to go at the producers, not the producers who want to produce good things, but the ones who are pushing what they know is destroying the people from the beats to the lyrics to all of that. Who is sanctioning this? Who approved it? And it's, you know, so again, that's on one half and then the artists, because a lot of them genuinely are ignorant.
Right.
They were like, this just me. Well, you just plucked me up out the hood fresh. This is what I was just talking about. You want me to put this on a beat? Okay. You going to pay me for it? Okay. You have that percentage.
Right. Right.
But then the real art gets drowned out again because it doesn't benefit the momentum of the agenda. That's why you get the real lyricists who get put on the back burner. That's why I love battle rap so much. Because it takes time. You got to think.
Yeah.
You have to. The biggest part.
Takes a level of intelligence.
Absolutely. The biggest part of battle. Okay. In battle, you must train for battle.
Right.
You have to sharpen the sword. You got to make sure the shield works. Your kicks is on point. You got to make sure all this works before you just go out there. That's not what they're doing for the majority. In battle rap, they're doing that. But out here, just in the classical mainstream, that's not clearly. Because we're like, what the hell did I just listen to? It hurts. Turn it off. You know, and it's like, okay. But my deal is I go straight to, who's around that person? See, I know the enemy. Mm-hmm. I always go to the enemy. I can't attack us. I got to go to the enemy. Sorry. And then bring responsibility to us after we educate one another. Once I give you that knowledge, then if you keep doing it, now you got to be held responsible heavily. You can't come at me. Well, I'm just, no. You ain't just being you. Knock that off. All right, because people dress that up. I'm just being me. No. You're not just being you. Because if I paid you to put on a dress and be modest, I paid you $1 million. You putting it on today. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Yeah. Sold for sale.
Come on.
Yep.
And that's not all of them.
Right.
But let's make it very clear. This enemy knows what he is doing. So we just got to stop acting as if we need to go and fall into that. We don't. We have enough industries, enough independent artists, groups, businesses, labels, organizations to where we quite literally don't need them anymore. Hollywood is dead. We just need to let it die. Let it. We got enough. Like you said, talk up. I see where the brother is. Mentally, right. I see. That's why I said, I know exactly where you are. Because I have that same feeling. The only difference is I direct it to the enemy. And then I got to come back and say, now look, damn, sit down.
This is what they, Let me tell you what they did to you.
This is what is happening here. All right? Do you know about this? Do you know about 360 deals? Do you know about a death clause in your agreements?
A nigga used to have no chill. Nowadays I bump side A. Traffic going bumper to bumper, stuck on the highway. Take so long to get from Monday to Friday. Then you wake up on Sunday like it was just Friday. Crime pays, I ain't caged, had to find ways. I wasn't trying to slave a 9 to 5 till my dying days. Friend,